Okay, welcome back to another episode of Programming Screeps. So one of the tricky things you got to do in this game is design it so that your code will work in the beginning of the game and middle of the game and late game. And you just don't break kind of all you've done when you come into a new room or you respawn. Because it's pretty easy to write the code for the moment, but it's hard to write code that transitions from early game to mid game to late game. So I'm thinking about how to do that in this case. So I manually built these containers, but I don't really want to manually build these containers. So I'm going to destroy them and I'll build them again. And what I really want to do is change my code so that I automatically build containers at the right spot and at the right time. And I also have these builder guys, and these builder guys aren't useful until the containers are built. So I don't want to build those either until we have containers. So let's kind of put the logic in place that will let me transition from these different stages. So I think what I want to do is in the build missing creeps section, I don't want to build these guys. So if our miners are done, if number of containers is less than kind of the sources, less than the sources length, how to define sources. Energy sources. So we'll define energy sources here. And that I think I've previously did. So I named it a position plus target. Alright, so I need to define that. Containers dot length. Equals find resource container structure container find So what can I find? Sources, dropped energy, my structures, construction sites. Structures. So we'll define this as structure and then this will be a filter on that. Structure dot type And we're looking for container. Something like this. And this guy will be exported. Structure, container. Let's see if that works. Maximum line length. I'm gonna get rid of that one too, because I don't really care that often about max line length. Alright, so now I have containers. So I'm not gonna build the builders until I have containers. So if I have all of my miners and all of my containers, and I need more builders, then I'll build them. Okay, that looks good. So back in my game, these are suicide these dudes. Let's see what's going on. Doesn't like my energy sources because I didn't define that. So when I define the room memory, so here's the different sources. RM dot, so RM dot source dot push. And basically I need a position plus target. Position plus target. Similar to that. Source pause. Source ID. I need to put this after this guy. And now I'm going to say source.pause.x. Is position. So the room object probably has position defined in it. Room position. It doesn't look like it. There's room position here. I'm just going to do X and Y, it's fine. Okay, and then I'll just increase the memory number to wipe and reset the memory. Sid Mem 5. Maybe I need to make an array first. Like this. It's already active. All right, there we go. All right, so we're back where we were. But now nobody's, of course, laying down the containers. So I think I want some code that for each energy source. I want a container. Container positions. Something like that. And after I define the mining task of all these positions, miner tasks. I want another array of for source, so this will keep track of all the mining tasks for a single source. This is all the sources, but for a single source is this one. So once I'm done calculating that, I want to get optimal container position given all the mining tasks for source and the source position, and the spawn. Do I know the spawn is? Let's give it the room. And then container pause. This guy is and this guy is in position plus target, and this is a room. Just faking this out for a second. Make sure it still builds. Just declare I've never used. Can I find name minor task? Okay, I'm just gonna fill up this guy. Source pause. Plus two. Does that work? Seems like it will. I'll just do a couple for loops. This one being Y. And the question is, how do we check a distance? Is there... direction to get range to. Okay, let's get a room pause. Source pause to X. If room pause equals null. Pause is not equal to null. Okay, room pause. Find or get range to X and Y. So if it's two away. Log info. Something like that. Finding optimal container pause for resources declared but never used. I'll just log it. It's empty. It's okay. Alright. Let's make sure we call this every frame until I debug it. Init room memory. Who calls init room memory? Okay, finding optimal for 3021. Source pause. So there should be two sources. Okay. Yes, so source, I think, so this is for each position. Don't want to do it there. Let's move it out one, like there. All right, that looks better. Should be Y. Okay, finding optimal. These ranges look messed up. Yeah, this should be Y. Okay, that looks good. see, for 30, 21, and it's looking at 28, comma 19. Saying the range is 2. And comma 19 all the way down to 22 less than or equal to 19, 20, 23. All right, so it's doing 5, 28, comma 23. Okay, that's good. Okay. So now, for everybody that's range 2, we'll do the same logic as this. Search pause is this stuff, and then we'll look at X and Y. Is not a wall. 29, 19. 19s are not a wall. Okay, good. Okay, I found all the range 2s that is not a wall. So I'm basically looking around it, finding all the non-walls 2 away, and then I will add the distance from each of the mining positions to that spot, and add the distance from that spot to the spawn, and then I will sort them. Choices. Node choice. Choice. equals. X, Y. Dist. Missing semicolon. Alright, so this distance I need to add up, not just the range, not the range, but now I need to say each. Is there like a sum? Some mining test for source. This is the room. So room dot spawn. Go find the spawns. I guess you can filter it right here. That's okay though. Don't need to filter it. Spawns dot length is 0. I'm not going to return anything either then. Spawn. Range. Get range to this. task dot x dot y if task pause. Turn 0. Else task get range 2 x and y. Some craziness like this. Twelve, 9. Yeah, looks like they're all kind of right. So kind of the lowest is what, 10? 30, come on, 19. That looks really good. Alright, good. So now I just need to sort these. Let's turn off this dumb logging everywhere. Now I need to down here after the choices sort. Wonder if it's the same syntax. Choices. Choice. No choice. Choice dot dist. Let's see, const sorted choices. Sub-zero dot dist. Best choice is choice is 34,18, 34. Yep, looks good. Exactly as I expect. target ID. I'm going to set it to no. Can this be no? No. I'll just set it to blank. Okay, I'm getting the optimal container position, and then I'm putting in this an array of container positions. Just get rid of this garbage. I'm not going to use this constructor. Okay, let's stop knitting the room memory every frame. And then inside here, so this can build if can. I'll make this a bit different for, I think, the mining guy, because he's only going to do the simple stuff. Let's see if there are no construction sites. There's also this containers thing. Get to this containers list is a question. Should be exporting it. Manager.containers, yeah. .length. If it's not equal to. Let's see, do I have the room memory somewhere in here? Of can or am. So if I haven't built all the containers, then I need to go build the construction sites. Let's see. Does a target dot structure type. I need to filter these two. Just container construction sites. Something like that. Let's see, inside minor it wants 192, wants triple equals 111. This block and empty. Get all fine container construction sites. So if I don't, then I'm going to creep.move to creep.build construct. Construction site. Let's go look at this worker guy. Build. So target is what? Construction site constructor. So over here, I just cast it to game structures. That's a construction site. Now I need to place this thing. Try to build extension, what I do there. Yeah, here we go, create construction site. So I just go into the room. Each of these guys. Container. What is this? Container pause, and it wants a room position. This may not be the best place to do it, but it seems like it'll work. If room pause is not equal to null, creating container at something like that. Building container. I don't really need to log it. It's kind of obvious. Lax return. Room manager. 242. See, everything else fails. Choice. Spin up the CLI server, script CLI, set tick rate. Have these guys move super fast until there's a bunch of them. I think they all died while I was programming. Oh, what's this? What What is this right here? That's a container. This is not good. Why is there a container there? Rooms, container position. Yeah, those look right. Minor. X, Y. Creep pause, no, not creep pause, room pause. That's why. Get rid of this shit. Stop. And set the tick rate back to 500 milliseconds. All right, perfect. Look at that. Automatically created the proper container positions by figuring out where to place them. And then in theory, it should build them. Yep, there it goes. It's building them. Nice. That's a good stopping point for the episode. Next time we'll actually use these containers once they're built. We'll change our logic so that once we have built the containers, we will no longer drop off the energy at the spawn or other locations. Once we build the containers and the builders, then we will start dumping stuff into these guys. All right, thanks for watching. See you next time.